Good morning, dear students. Hope each one of you is doing good. Today we are going to read a very important chapter, A Thousand Paper Cranes. It's a story of a young and courageous girl, Sadako Sasaki. The chapter is written by a Canadian-born author, Eleanor Coyer, who has written a number of books for children, including Sadako and Thousand Paper Cranes. If we look at the summary of this chapter, the story is based on the life of a young girl, Sadako, who was dying of leukemia caused by the use of the atom bomb in World War II. The paper cranes are viewed as a sign of good luck. If a sick person folded 1,000 of them, the gods would grant their wish and make them healthy again. Sadako worked hard during her illness and was able to fold 644 cranes before she died. Her classmates folded 356 more so that the cranes could be buried with their friend. Now let's talk about Sadako Sasaki. She was born on January 7, 1943. She lived near Misasa Bridge in Hiroshima, Japan. She was only 2 years old when the atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima on August 6, 1945. As she grew up, Sadako was a strong, courageous, and athletic girl. However, in 1955, when she was 11 years old, while practicing for a big race, she became dizzy and fell to the ground and was diagnosed with the atom bomb disease. Now let's look at the story. One young Japanese girl named Sadako Sasaki was born in 1943. She was only 2 years old when the bomb was dropped on Hiroshima. Although she was too young to remember the war, every year she took part in the peace celebrations in Hiroshima because her grandmother died during the war. As Sadako grew up, she was strong, courageous, and athletic. In the year 1955, she was preparing for a big race. It was an important event for her. But while practicing for that, she became dizzy and fell down. Very soon, she was taken to the hospital. And when she was examined, she was diagnosed with leukemia, blood cancer, in November 1954. According to one version of the story, while she was in the hospital, her best friend Chizuko Hamamoto came to the hospital to visit and cut a gold piece of paper into a square to fold it into a paper crane and taught Sadako of an old folk tale. In the ancient Japanese story, it was promised that anyone who folds 1,000 paper cranes will be granted a wish from gods. So, she started folding paper cranes and she managed to make many paper cranes. As she finished the crane, she made a second wish and wrote that wish on the wings of a crane. peace because she was a victim and prayed that her crane would fly over the whole world and proclaim, "This is our cry, this is our prayer, peace for the world." That is what was required at that point of time when the whole world was suffering. Sadly, Sadako only managed to complete 644 paper cranes before dying on the 25th October 1955 at the age of 12. The remaining 356 cranes were folded by her school friends so that she could be buried with 1,000 paper cranes. Sadako's determination was an inspiration for her friends and those who knew her. They begin to dream of a monument for her that would be a symbol of hope and the determination to carry on no matter what. They also wanted the memorial to stand for all of the children who had lost their lives as a result of the atomic bomb, those who died instantly, and those like Sadako who died later. The city has since been rebuilt as a peace memorial city, and the city strongly backs the abolition of the use of nuclear weapons. In it is the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Park. In this park stands a statue of Sadako Sasaki, originally a survivor of the Hiroshima bombing, who later became a victim of the after effects of nuclear warfare. So this peace monument serves as a symbol for many. There are numerous memorials in Japan for the children affected by the Hiroshima disaster, as well as a statue of Sadako. Every day, the memorial is covered with paper cranes in the hope for world peace, so that a disaster such as this one will never prevail again. And that is what we also wish for at this point of time. Let peace prevail everywhere. So this is our cry, this is our prayer, peace in the world. So that was all for this story.